None of the Borg systems appears to be operational.
He's right. They're adrift.
As far as we can tell, all activity on the Borg ship ceased abruptly 5 years ago. It is possible that the deactivation of the ship and its systems severed the link with the rest of the collective.
Five years ago, our cube was damaged by an electrokinetic storm. The next thing we knew, our link to the collective was severed. We were free.
The Borg collective consciousness is extremely powerful. It allowed us to transfer information instantaneously, to think with one mind. But what you may not be aware of is the link also has inherent medical applications. We were connected by a continuous neuroelectric field that was capable of regenerating the damaged components of an injured Borg.
We have the ability to relink our brain patterns.
We could generate a neuroelectric field that could heal your injuries.
Hook up my mind to some Borg collective.
No.
You'd simply be linked for a limited period of time to Riley, me, and a few of the others in our group willing to help you.
I'm not letting anyone implant some neural processor in my brain.
That wouldn't be necessary. I'd simply attach a small neurotransceiver to the base of your skull. We'd initiate the link, and the transceiver could be removed as soon as the procedure was over.
Don't be afraid, Chakotay. We're here to help you. Open your mind to our thoughts.
I heard all of you, your thoughts inside my head. I know so much about you.
We shared a very rare experience.
I felt that.
It's a residual effect from the link.
How long will it last?
An hour. Long enough. Can you still hear what I'm thinking?
Yes.
Then you know I want to be closer to you. I want you to feel everything I feel. And we believe the solution to our problem is to reestablish the neural link among all the former Borg living on the planet.
You can't be serious.
And when we were linked, we had no ethnic conflict. There was no crime. No hunger, no health problems. We lived as one harmonious family.
You were one harmonious family bent on the violent assimilation of innocent cultures.
But we're not Borg anymore. And we've learned from our past. All we want to do is to take the one good thing that existed in the midst of all that horror. Our unique ability to cooperate and problem solve and use it to create a safe and productive community. The neurotransponder we've built is only powerful enough to link a small group of people. In order to reconnect the entire population permanently, we'd need a much bigger neuroelectric field generator.
I'm afraid we don't have anything like that.
But the Borg cube does.
What they're asking us to do is reactivate that ship's neuroelectric generator and redirect it toward the planet.
And in all the time you were linked, you never sensed anything negative. No hidden agenda, no destructive intent.
No.
I'll reserve some holodeck time as soon as we're back.
Chakotay, can you hear us?
Did you say something?
No.
Are you getting a comm transmission?
No. Why?
Must have been my imagination.
Chakotay, we need your help.
Chakotay.
We need your help.
I'm going to tell the doctor he needs to take a look at you as soon as we're back.
Don't do that.
Chakotay, give me the phaser.
Captain, Commander Chakotay's shuttle has changed course.
You must do this.
Audio transmission, Captain.
From the planet's surface.
We are the new cooperative. We have destroyed the Borg cube. We regret that we forced Commander Chakotay to assist us, but it was necessary for our survival. His link with the cooperative has now been severed. our lasting gratitude.
His neuropeptide levels have returned to normal.
And there are no residual traces of the link?
None.
How were they able to reestablish the connection?
My best guess is that the residual neuropeptides heightened his telepathic receptivity.
I thought their limited equipment made it impossible for them to form the link over great distances.
Apparently, once they repaired their communications array, they were able to use it to amplify the signal from their neural transponder.
I don't know what to say, except I'm sorry.
Based on what the doctors told us, it's clear you were acting against your will.
Maybe so, but somehow that doesn't make me feel any better.
But so far, they haven't acted like typical Borg. They saved us from that cube, and they let you go.
But they didn't hesitate to impose their collective will on me when it served their interests, did they?
No, they didn't.
I wonder how long their ideals will last in the face of that kind of power.